So we use a technology called pulse light processing for inactivating microorganisms in various food products. So this is a broad spectrum light with wavelengths ranging from 100 to 1100 nanometer. So it has UV light, visible light, and portion of infrared light. So this is very powerful, so that the energy of each of the pulses is very, very high. It is sufficient for inactivating different microorganisms. And the pulse light technology can also be used for enhancing vitamin D content in some of the food products. For example, if we treat white button mushrooms with pulse light for just 1 second, we can increase the vitamin D to content by more than 700% just with 1 second. So for some of the food products, it works really great. And this technology can also be used for reducing allergenicity in food products. We can also use it for inactivating toxins in the food products. Pulse light technology had been proved to be very effective in inactivating microorganisms. So within our lab, we are working on inactivation of different microorganisms like Salmonella or E. coli or Listeria from various surfaces of fruits and also fruit juices and like other kind of food products. But we want to better understand how this inactivation actually takes place so that we can better optimize the technology for improved inactivation. The effect of these factors, so those are going to be really crucial for successful commercialization of this particular technology.